Hello YouTubers, this is the review of my minigun. I say review because I built it, so I'm going to be totally biased and sing its praises and fail to tell you about all the flaws that it may have. Okay, it's an AIM M4 inside a body shell that I made, mainly of plastic. All of this is plastic, some bits of wood, and some of it is an old joystick that I got for a fiver. Bargain. Right, basically how it works, the gun's under here, move those out of the way. 9.6 volt battery that goes in. La, quick test. Excellente. Right in there. 3.2 volt battery. Pop that in there. Get that out of the way. Also, there is another plug here. This is for this. 3,000 rounds auto winding mag from Hero's Arms. It's a piece of crap. It doesn't feed, and when it does, it only does about 50 to 60 shots. So as a support weapon, it is totally useless and a waste of 60 quid really, but at least I'll have an interesting looking paperweight or something to throw at cats in my garden maybe. Right, that is all good to go except for this ordinary mag. I'm planning on getting a big old box mag to put in there maybe. I don't know, there's a big gaping hole in the bottom now, looks a bit crap, but whatever. Ordinary mag will work, stick that in there. Changing mags is a piece of piss as well. You just find the little button which is there and out it comes. Easy peasy, so changing it in the field won't exactly be difficult. Pop that in, give it a little wind, click, click, click. And that is good to go. Only problem with that mag is it now is on the piss. That's why I wanted the other mag. It sits nice and flush to my little table thingy. Anyway, dummy rounds, they're quite cool. Joystick, that button would reload it had the mag not stopped working, so that does nothing now, as does that one. That one spins the barrels, this one makes it shoot. Press them both together and you can unleash hell on anyone who stands at the business end of your gun. That's pretty much it really. Now let's get on to shooting some random stuff. First of all, let's compare rate of fire and size. My M4, I quite happily wield this one hand, no problem. And this is how fast it is, or isn't. Yeah. Try wielding this with one hand is a little more troublesome. It's about 3 foot long and weighs a little over 8 kilograms when it's fully loaded, so it's quite heavy. And if you haven't got a sling, then you're gonna have sore arms by the end of the day. Anyway, let's fuck some shit up. Wouldn't want that to be me. Where's the old DVD? There we go. So there you have it, old Painless. Right, just a couple of things that people will be asking me on the Arnie's Airsoft forums. Rate of fire, I don't know. You saw what it did to that can. in just a few seconds. So I'd say rate of fire pretty damn fast. Power, it's 330 feet per second ish, give or take. That's what the manufacturer said on the gun. Took 2 years to build roughly. Cost just for one of these, not including the countless amounts of times I had to redo things, is about 250-300 quid. But like I said, 2 years worth of redoing stuff, trial and error, it costs a bit more than that. I've got some dummy rounds, most of it's made of PVC gutter piping, barrel is made of plastic, little quarter screwdriver to make the barrel spin. Like I said before, the gun inside it is an AIM M4. Basically, I've cut everything off of that it doesn't need. The gun is still one piece. I've tried to keep the gun here simple as possible, so less things to go wrong with it. The only thing I think that can go wrong with it is you run out of ammo. The amount of times between takes I had to wind this stupid thing or fill it up. If I'd got a quid for each time, I could build like 10 of these, I think. Yeah, and that's it really.